Hi, my name is Melissa Tornero Bold, and I am one of the interventional pain physicians at the Ohio State University Wexner Medical Center. Spinal cord stimulation is a process similar to a pain pacemaker, where one or more thin wires are placed near the spine and connected to an energy source. These wires provide electrical impulses to act as a pain scrambler to help nerves quiet down painful signals communicating between the spinal cord and the brain. First, a trial procedure is performed, which small wires are placed through small needles through the skin. It is very similar to an epidural injection, but instead of medicine being placed, the thin wires, otherwise known as leads, are placed in the epidural area. This procedure is done in outpatient surgery and only under sedation. Patients do very well with this. Following this, there's a trial period where you go home and go about your daily activities. This trial period usually lasts about a week. You will get a remote control to turn the device on and off and to adjust the therapy. If it helps your pain greatly, then you are a candidate for the implantable procedure. The benefits of a spinal cord stimulator are several. It is pain relief for many patients that nothing else has given long-term benefit. The first successful case of spinal cord stimulation was actually in 1967, so it has a proven long-term track record as being effective and safe. It provides you with a trial period to see if you love the therapy. The stimulation can be threshold, which means that you are able to feel it working, or subthreshold, where it is delivering energy, but you do not feel the stimulation. Every person is different, and different people have different preferences. In this regard, it is extremely customized therapy. With a wide array of different pain coverage patterns, it is an extremely personalized therapy to cover your painful areas that need it most. Because it is minimally invasive outpatient surgery, there is decreased recovery time compared to many other spine surgeries or reoperations. It's covered by insurance companies because it has a proven track record. One of the side effects of long-term morphine-like medicines is that patients develop tolerance requiring increase in the dosages of these medicines. Unfortunately, with increasing dosages, there are increasing side effects of these medicines. Spinal cord stimulation should be considered by anyone suffering from chronic intractable pain that has not responded to more conservative therapy. This includes pain of the trunk, low back, arm, or legs. It is for people with failed back surgery syndrome, chronic pain syndrome, complex regional pain syndrome, and pain in the arms or legs from nerve damage. I would recommend to anyone who is searching for evidence-based treatment that works to schedule an appointment with Ohio State Comprehensive Spine Center to see if a spinal cord stimulator is appropriate for you.